In Lech Lecha portion, while we are entering the stories of the founding fathers and mothers of the Jewish nation, we must comprehend something extremely important. Each one of the figures that we are about to encounter, as well as the figures that will appear in the as we travel during the portions of the Torah, also in the other books of the Torah, each figures are is displayed there not only as human figures or characters in a story, but also as an actual landmarks that were created within creation for the sake of our education. These figures or characters are there to teach us of how to be more inclined with our inmost deepest soul and in its diverse layer of existence. We should consider each one of these figures, starting here in the book of Bereshit, but as I said, also as we move forward, meaning that we are about to encounter with Abraham, Yitzchak, Yaakov, Sarah, Rivka, Rachel, Leah, and Yaakov's sons and his daughter, and then also, but afterwards, when we will get to the portions of Sefer Shmot and to the characters that we will encounter there, as Moshe, Aaron, Miriam, Yocheved, Yitro, v'chulei, all those figures are not there only as figures or characters in the story, but they are also forces within ourselves. Each one of these forces enter in a different part of the story by means of educating us in regards to our abilities or about the suggested behavior that we should take or must follow as humans in this world in the relevant timing of their appearance, not only as humans but also as more in a more profound way as humans that are educated by the divine, by God, and are walking through the path of the Torah. So we can see or look at Lech Lecha portion as the starting point of the great journey of consciousness we are about to take, the Jewish consciousness. And we are accompanied now by its first figure, which is really exciting, to be honest, with Avraham, Avraham's figure, Avraham's spirit, Avraham's force is entering the biblical story, which is means that is entering our life. And Avraham as well as Sarah contains great deal of secrets that clarifies us much about our soul, our high neshama, which is the more elevated form of the soul, of the Jewish psyche, both nationally, but also in a very personal way. As we are entering the beginning of this very special, personal, but as we know also very collective journey, we can unwrap Avraham's story or recognize in it few layers. The first would be the simple way of looking at the scripture, the simple way of reading the texts, the understanding of it in the most plain way that there is. The second will be a deeper level of understanding. We will look at the story and of Avraham's character as an allegory to our high neshama, to our soul. The third way would be to dive even further and into a deeper understanding, as we will recognize in the story and in Avraham's character parts of ourselves. So let us start now with the first, with the pshat, with a simple way of looking and reading through this story. Where Avraham is being asked by Hashem, go forth from your land, from your birthplace, and from your father's house to the place that I will show you. From your land and from your birthplace, we know that Avraham was situated with his family in Haran, and then he must then was requested from Hashem to go out from this place, from Haran, to another land, a different land, a land that God will show him. From the house of your father, we know that Avraham's father, Terach, was not only an idol worshipper, but also an idol manufacturer. So by the command that has been given to Avraham to go from Terach's house would be the command to go from a place of idol worshipping and impurity to the land that I will show you, to out of idol worshipping and into starting a process to purify himself. So now let's unwrap it and move towards the deeper level of understanding and look at how Avraham figure or character is basically an allegory to the Ha'Neshama, to our soul. So the Zohar in this portion of Lech Lecha unfolds the hidden layers of the evolution of the soul. If before in Bereshit portion we had the evolution of creation, and then later on in Noach portion we came across the evolution of the human race, or in a way its survival, and therefore it's also evolution. Now using Avraham as a prototype figure, we are about to reveal our evolution of the soul. Avraham's story teaches us about the true meaning of belief, as well as about our true nature of as people with spiritual foundation, and also it teaches us about our soul journey to this world. The Zohar's portion uses the commandment God gave to Avraham in means of educating and teaching us about the process of the soul as it leaves the spiritual upper realms that are in heaven and enter the physical lower realms of our material existence. Lech Lecha signifies a celestial genetic DNA code of the nation of Israel. So Lech Lecha me'artzecha mimoladetcha umibayt avicha. Avraham signifies the Ha'Neshama, and therefore go forth from your land, from the dwelling place of the soul, of where the soul was produced, which is in the upper realms, umimoladetcha, from your birthplace, from the soul's initial place, the chair of honor, or the chair of the souls, as the Zohar refers it to, which is located up in the skies, from the sky, from the divine territories located in the upper realms, up in the heavens. So here in Lech Lecha, we are giving a glimpse into the journey of the Ha'Neshama as it goes from its initial birthplace up in the heavens all the way down to earth. After the Neshama, the soul, has passed through this journey out of the divine territories in heavens and into the earth, after it evolved from its metaphysical state to a physical state, we then can see the sentence that we have here in a completely different way. Go forth from your land and from your birthplace and from your father's house to the land that I will show you, says God to the Neshama, which is signified by Avraham. The soul, the Ha'Neshama, having descended from all its lofty ranks and dressed in the physical body, gains now the power to walk also in the lower realms, knowing though its high spiritual origin and forces. To the land I will show you, a land that will reveal to you something new, a land in which you will be able to get an ultimate elevation, because we know that by doing commandments and mitzvot, using this world as a corridor to the next life. Now let's unwrap it even further and touch the third layer of understanding of this verse of Lech Lecha. Lech Lecha, from your land. We know that each time in the Zohar, when the word land appears, we know it signifies or he talks about a will, the human desire of some sort. So go Lech Lecha from your land, from your human wills and desires. You should go out from these, from your birthplace, from all assumptions you may have which are influenced by and are aligned with the human perception of the mortal mind that you have, from your father's house, from things that are rooted in causes and reasons of education and habit, things you have learned from other human figures in this world, in this lifetime. This portion teaches us that we are to step out from these and go into the land which God will show us, meaning we are to willingly choose to consciously leave any wills or desires we may possess, or any knowledge we acquired in regards to the desires that we have under human assumptions and habits lay within our mortal mindset, and even to leave our whatever we learned in regards to our human perspective, in terms of human education, whatever we've learned also doesn't count anymore. To the land I will show you, to try and reach beyond human perspective, perception, acknowledgement, understandings, or as sages love to say, lemala mita'am vida'at. We need to go above and beyond our knowledge, above and beyond what we know, above and beyond the rational. So, but this is not all. There is more to this layer. According to Avraham's journey in Lech Lecha portion, we are to reach out beyond the borders of our very human mindset, also when it comes to our human perception of the divine and of what we think the divine wants from us, where we are to reach out and beyond the divine observation we think we might hold. We are to step out from whatever we possess under any perception of human assumption in regards to the divine will when it comes to our matter. Or in other words, we are to erase everything completely and start again, start from scratch, like a whiteboard. This is Lech Lecha. Lech Lecha from the land means also stepping onwards or outwards from any human perceptions one may have in regards to the divine will, from your birthplace, from our thoughts, when it comes to belief in terms of whatever we think belief is actually is, and from your father's house, from what you think, even under the divine perception you think that you reckon. So we see we have here the first and simple way of looking at Abraham's story of Lech Lecha verse, as a man leaving his land, leaving his birthplace, leaving his father's house. But also we need to read the story under the layer of the celestial genetic DNA code of our neshama, of the soul, the journey of the high neshama from the heavens to the earth. And then also in the advanced layer, which asks us to leave every earthly will or desire that we have and every mortal education we received, to then later even to leave our thoughts and perceptions in regards to the divine or what we think we know of the divine. And then there is another interpretation of the Lech Lecha. It can be readed as go to yourself. Lech Lecha, go to yourself. Avraham's movement towards the fulfillment of his tasks. Going has the connotation of moving forward and moving towards one fulfillment and ultimate purpose. Go to yourself, meaning go towards your soul essence and your ultimate purpose, that for which you were created to begin with. That this is the command of God from Avraham, and this is our command in this portion, because when reading the Torah, we should look at what God said to Abraham, the Lech Lecha. We are to read it as if those words were speaking from the divine, especially to us. As we can see, Avraham, which signifies our high neshama in its primal stage of creation, was given a complicated task, and we are to follow him and fulfill this task in the upcoming year, and especially in this week. So this command given to Avraham as the chosen figure in his generation to start the notion of the monotheistic belief is enormous. And Avraham started a journey that was about to move him progressively towards an ever-increasing degree of holiness that will eventually manifest itself in all nations. But also, we can look at it at a simple request from God towards us, our little very tiny cosmos of self, our soul. Then, after we erased our perception, acknowledgement, assumptions, and everything that we knew in regards to our wills and ourselves, and even what we thought God wants from us and his wills and his desires, then naturally we will suddenly find ourselves in an empty place, in space, in a vacuum. And there was a famine in the land, natural, because if the land is our will, and then the moment that we step went out from this land, or took everything out from this land to start fresh, to start again, then obviously there is some sort of hunger now that we feel, some emptiness inside. So what is the right direction now? What is the right approach? What do I need to do? What would be the right food for me to take inside my body, mind, heart and soul and spirit? And there was the famine in the land, and Abraham went down to Egypt. Why this sudden reversal of Abraham's spiritual journey, or even in our continual progress towards fulfillment? The answer is simple. We must understand that Abraham's mission, as well as the entire Jewish nation's mission, is not simply a personal one, but a global one. His task, as well as our tasks, is to spread God's name and gather in adherence to his faith in all nations. Egypt, back in the days, was the ultimate haven to idol worshipping. It was also the superpower state. Everything went between and on and from Egypt. And so, therefore, the lowest place on earth would be the most important place for us to start manifesting this belief, for Abraham to start manifest his new belief, the monotheistic belief. And this is exactly where God sent him. Now, that is to show us that every one of us has the capacity to leave a temporarily insignificant position, or even a high significant position for that matter, and to go to a land that God will show us, to go to an unknown place, to start an enigmatic journey, to be in a complete surrender with the divine will, the true divine will, not necessarily the divine will that we presume that we have, that there is. This week's portion enables us to recognize that we can and must leave our present position, and by sheer effort cause Hashem to show us the true land, the real land, the promised land, our true actual goal. We will learn more of this together as we travel in the portions, but for now, let us move forward in this portion and in our understandings when it comes to our soul and to the right way of conducting ourselves in means of belief. Abraham had two sons, Ishmael and Yitzhak. Those two can be looked at as two human figures in the pshat, in the simple way of looking at the script of the text, in the simple way of observing the story. But also here we can reach beyond and travel onwards to see two types of belief, out of which, of course, we would be directed to prefer one above the other. The Lubavitcher Rebbe teaches us that Ishmael and Yitzhak differed in two significant aspects. The first, Ishmael came into the world by natural means, by natural causes, while Yitzhak's birth was a supernatural event. As we know, Abraham and Sarah gave birth to Yitzhak when they were extremely old people, and therefore this thing was a miraculous thing and wasn't according to natural order of things. And the second, Ishmael was circumcised at the age of 13, an age of awareness, an age that he already gained some sort of identity. And whereas Yitzhak entered into the covenant of the circumcision as an 8-day-old infant, as a little baby, at an age which a person is not even aware of what is taking place, much less of what this act actually signifies. So looking at it, we can come to the conclusion that Ishmael represents a rational relationship with Hashem, one that is based upon a person's nature and mortal awareness, while Yitzhak represents a supernatural and irrational bond between the divine and us. Abraham saw many positive qualities in Ishmael and was prepared and even desired to see him as his heir. Yet God insisted that this covenant be perpetuated specifically through Yitzhak and Yitzhak descendants, whose committed to God will transcend the natural and rational. Ishmael grew up in Abraham's home, and his upbringing brought him under his father's way of educating him to the intellectual understandings in regards to the relationship between Hashem and him. However, when something comes out of mental understanding or from intellect alone, there isn't any certainty to it, and therefore any change in perception or in perspective eventually can bring doubt to this understanding and prevent its continuation. In other words, Ishmael had a rational understanding of belief, and this understanding would be limited and adjusted only as long as the mind will accept it under laws of mortal understanding, of human understanding. Whereas the position of Yitzchak and his descendants, generations, Israel, has no dependency to natural causes or human mindset of understanding. Israel's existence and essence is due to be supernatural, miraculous, and irrespective of the limitations of nature. And we also can see that it's not limited in according to one's mind and opinion, but will be infused by devotion, continuous devotion. To sum it up, when it comes to Jewish beliefs in regards to the attachment needed between man and Hashem, man and God, God and man, one should not rely on the relationship by virtue of the human mind, but the devotion of the soul. The high neshama, which we have just learned of its first steps in this world with Abraham's figure within this beautiful story of Lech Lecha portion that received the command of Lech Lecha, it has nothing to do with human calculations, understandings, or assumptions, and therefore cannot and must not be based on them. Our soul is uplifted, and it is not to be limited and by measurements or calculations of the human mind. We are connected with the divine in an unbreakable bond of the covenant. Abraham opened a pipe of devotion in mind, body, spirit, and soul, we can say. But just as Abraham, we are too obligated to continue a very unhuman, or better to say, spiritual journey while we are dressed in our human figures. So in this week, in this portion, in Lech Lecha week, feel Avraham and Sarah forces enter inside your heart. Use them and use their characteristic to better understand how to cope with relevant issues that occur in your life. Acknowledge the divine request for you. Leave all your past assumptions and acknowledgements. What you think, what you want, what you think that you want, and let God take you to whatever is it that He wants. Let God take you to wherever you are truly supposed to go. Have a Shabbat Shalom, and I hope to see you next week when we would probably speak about Yitzchak figure or touch this subject. Have a great Shabbat.